Hi guys, welcome to our channel Silicon Valley Gardener. Hope you all are staying safe and healthy. In today's blog, let's take a tour of our garden. Look at all our plants, see how they are doing. Also, let's take a look at what all vegetables we harvested this month, what new plants we added to our garden, and let's take a look at our regular maintenance work we do in the garden. Why to delay further? Let's jump into the tour of our garden. This is our clementine tree. It had a lot of fruits this year. It had so many fruits that the plant could not bear the weight anymore. It started leaning down and we had to provide some extra support, and that still doesn't seem to be enough support for it. So our green vegetable bed is all grown fully. So this is our gongura Malabar spinach. Look at the Malabar spinach, it's become massive. So the sorrel leaf bed is all ready and seeded. We can save these flowers and we can use it as a seed for next year. Look at the flowers, see how beautiful they look. It looks like some nice flower bed or something like that. So these are our capsicum plants, they're all growing. Looks like they need more sun. So since the temperatures are warming up here in the Silicon Valley, they're all growing. And look at the capsicum. Yeah, within few days, they should be ready to be harvested. And look at our flower bed. These are all the marigold flowers that we have. This is the blanket flower that we have. And here are all our tulsi plants that we have, the holy basil. Look at the color of that marigold. It looks so lovely, right? Yeah, I have used these flowers to make garlands for a few rituals this month. And look at the curry leaf plant. It's loving the warm weather outside. And look at the growth. There are a lot of new leaves. And it's growing. It's doing great. Happy for that. So the watermelons are growing. Look at that big watermelon there, and there are a few smaller ones here and there. Yeah, there are a few there. And this is the vegetable bed that we made earlier last week, month, I guess. So we planted few okra and eggplant there, and they're growing. And also we made another vegetable bed here, if you remember. I'll link the video on the corner. So there are few eggplants and few lemon cucumber here which are growing right now. And there are few dahlia. And here there is another marigold bed that we made. And the herbs are growing. So this is the tulsi or holy basil that we planted in the ground. And this is the oregano that we planted, and both are doing great. And the roses are in full bloom. The banana plant is growing well, and here are a few more eggplants. They're doing great. They're loving the warm temperatures, and they're continuously giving us few eggplants every week. And then this is the these are the other variety of eggplants that are growing here, and they're doing great as well. And this is the bitter melon. It's doing good. And the Meyer lemon is growing slow, and the rose plants are doing well as usual. And the fig plant is doing great, actually. The tomatoes are grown into massive plants. It's hard to control their growth. Look at the figs. They look lovely, right? Our sunflowers are in full bloom this month. We totally loved the sunflowers this season. We used them for decor, and we also harvested the seeds. I have to see how I can use those seeds later, but these are the lovely sunflowers. And look at the bees that they are attracting. This is our drumstick plant that we planted from seed last month. The plants are slowly growing. And these are all the flowers that we plucked from the garden. This is how we tried to decorate our kitchen window. It looks lovely, right? We totally love this view. We usually don't have rains in August, but this year we had a rain, like a thunderstorm in August. And to be frank, since the weather was so warm, I totally loved the rain, and it was so pleasant to watch the rain. And this is how it looks. It looks so pleasing and pleasant. I just wanted to show you a glance of how the garden looked in rain and after the rain. Hope you liked it. So these are a few figs that we harvested this month. So the ripened ones look black in color. And when you touch them, they have a very soft texture. That means that the fruits are ripened and ready to be harvested. So we are harvesting few figs that are ready. And this is how they look. And when you cut them, this is how they look. We also harvested few cucumbers this month. So for cucumbers, it's a little tricky because if you don't harvest them at the right time, they grow massive, and sometimes they even turn a little bit bitter. So you have to harvest them in the right time. So if you look at these cucumbers, this is the size that's right for them to be harvested. And if you harvest them at the right time, they taste really good and juicy. And it's very hard to find them because they are green and they are hidden behind the leaves. So you have to keep looking for them. And this is the harvest. So these are the cucumbers that we harvested. This is the chili plant that we have in our garden. So one plant is good enough for us. So it gives us enough chilies that we use on a day-to-day basis in our curries or anything that we do. So this is amazing. So this is the eggplant harvest that we are doing. We have a few variety of eggplants in our garden. So this is one variety. It produces large eggplants that are dark blue in color, but if you cook them, they're very tender. So this is another variety. It has purple eggplants, and this is our favorite. So this cooks really fast, and they are very tasty. So these are few harvests that we did this month. This is the okra harvest that we are doing. This is one of the few harvests that we did this month. So with okra, the trick is you have to harvest them at the right time. If you leave them on the plant for too long, they'll become thick and useless for cooking. So you have to harvest them when you see that they're tender. Otherwise, you just have to leave them on the plant so they can become seed, and you can use that for next year as a starter, like a seed starter. So here are a few other okras. We had two variety of okra in our garden. This is the Indian variety that we had, which is very tender, and there is another variety, and this is the harvest. These are few harvests that we did this month. So So this is the purple bean plant we have in our garden this year. This is a great addition to the garden if you want to attract a lot of hummingbirds, butterflies and bees in our garden. Especially the flowers of this plant are very attractive and they keep attracting all these birds and butterflies. So we are harvesting the beans. So the only thing is you have to boil these beans very well before cooking, and you can make a great bean curry out of it and it tastes really good. So I harvested few beans this month, and I also stored few beans for cooking in the winter as well. So we have this bottle gourd variety. It's a long bottle gourd that we planted this year, and we had two plants actually, and they are doing amazing. It's a blast. We had I can't even remember, I think it's 20 bottle gourds that we harvested. We tried to share it with all our friends, neighbors, and we made a lot of varieties with this bottle gourd, and the flavor is amazing. This variety of bottle gourd has a very nice flavor to it, and the harvest is also like amazing. This is the size it grows. If you leave it, it can become like totally huge. So you have to harvest this at the right time. The smaller it is, the tender it is, and the tastier it is. So you have to keep watching these bottle gourds, and usually when the temperature raises, they grow massive. So you have to keep monitoring them every day and then harvest them at the right time. So this is the harvest we did this month. So this is the tomato harvest that we are doing. So these are the cherry tomatoes. We didn't plant this. Somehow we had this guest plant in our garden this year, and it's just one plant, but the amount of tomatoes it produces is truly amazing. Like one plant it gives you like a lot of tomatoes, like cherry tomatoes, and we use them in the salads. And this is the Roma tomato variety that we have. I started this plant from seed this year, and it was slow, but when the temperatures raised, it started producing a lot of tomatoes, and all the tomatoes started turning red. And this is one of the harvests that we did this month, and we are totally loving this. We are harvesting few carrots that we planted in March. So we started these carrots in a pot from seed. We planted these seeds in March, and by August we were able to harvest them. We couldn't find any space in the soil, so in the ground, so we tried to plant them in the container, and they did great. If you look at the size of these carrots, they grew very well, and we totally liked the flavor of these carrots. They are super juicy and very nice. So only problem is you have to use a bigger pot. If you use a smaller pot, the bottom of these carrots would twist. So if you use a bigger, like a longer pot, they'll be straight. So this is how they looked after cleaning them. We also harvested few beans. So this is an amazing crop. If you want to plant anything that is low maintenance, you can plant these bush beans. So this is a bush bean variety. So it's not a vein, so you don't have to build a trellis or anything. It's a bush variety. And I found the seeds in Home Depot. You just have to plant them, and they sprout in a week, and then you can transplant them into the ground. The yield is amazing. Like in this month, we harvested like 4 or 5 times, and it's an amazing yield. And the beans are very tender, and I made like curry out of these beans, and it tasted super yummy. So this is definitely a low maintenance crop that you can add to your garden for sure. We had like 10 plants, and every week we had almost this amount of harvest or even more than this. So yeah, this is a good addition to the garden. So this is the capsicum harvest that we are doing. So yeah, we started this plants from seed. We got regular store-bought capsicum, and while cooking I tried to save the seeds, and we tried to sprout these seeds early this year, and then we were able to get few plants that we tried to transplant them into the soil, and by August this is how they grew, and the harvest is massive. So we had couple of harvests this month, and they're very healthy plants, and even the capsicum looked very healthy. You can cut them whenever you want. You can let them grow a little bigger, or you can even cut them when they're tender, and you can make anything that you want. So these are few plants that we had, and this is the minimum harvest we get every week from these capsicum plants, and these are good enough for our consumption. These are the lemon cucumbers that we planted this year in the soil, and they are doing amazing. Usually when we plant them in the raised beds, they always grew a little smaller. They used to be the size of lemons, but we had extra plants, and then we planted them in the ground, and they are doing amazing. The size of the cucumbers are huge. So this month we tried to propagate few jasmine plants from the stems we have from the existing plant. So this is the existing plant we had, and if you see, it had few stems that were leaning downwards, so we tried to cut few stems, so that way the plant has more space and more room to grow. And then we tried to use those stems to propagate new plants. So this is one of the stem we are trying to use. So since this is a longer stem, we tried to cut it into two, so that way we can use these two stems to propagate. And we just tried to use these stems, we put these stems into soil, and after a month, this is what we see right now. This is the growth. I see two stems being propagated. So these are the two jasmine stems that we tried to propagate this month, and we are happy about it. Here we are preparing the soil so we can plant the new plant we had. So if you look, this is the compost that we were making. If you look at the compost, we added all the kitchen scrape and everything into it, and look at the quality of the compost. It's all ready. You don't see any kitchen scrape or anything. It's all turned into soil and ready to be used. So we are trying to mix this compost into our potting soil. So we are just breaking down that the hard particles that we had. And this is the henna plant that I found online. I wanted to have this plant from a long time, but this year I could find one, so I ordered this, and we are trying to transplant it to a bigger pot, and we tried to use the potting mix that we used earlier to transplant this. So we have to protect this in winter. And also we are pollinating our bottle gourds, because we had to hand pollinate them because we do not have enough bees in the garden. So this is our regular garden maintenance. We remove a few weeds that we have in the garden, so that way the garden stays clean, and that way we can also save the plants from few infections and pests as well. And also, if you don't remove the weeds, they take up all the nutrients in the soil, and the plant that has to grow wouldn't grow. So you always have to clean the weeds in the garden. And these are few aphids that we see on our okra plants. So these aphids would let your okra plants produce less okras, and they'll also eventually make the plant grow weaker, and then eventually the plant might even die. So you have to treat them. We want to treat them in an organic way, so we are trying to use this neem oil. So we get this neem oil in any home store. So we get this neem oil, and then we just spray it on all these leaves. So if the infection is more, you can just pluck the leaves and throw away. But if you think it could be treated with this neem oil, you just have to spray wherever you see this infection, and that should help the plant get rid of that infection, and you can protect the plant. So these are the harvests that we made this month. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe to our channel, and please don't forget to leave your comments or feedback in the comment section. Thank you.